Yes, students, good morning. And in the continuation of video lectures, today we are going to start the new chapter, most interesting chapter, which is the mechanical properties of fluids, part first. So, dear students, till now, as you had studied about the mechanical properties of solids, and in case of solids, we had discussed that when the force is applied on the solid, then deformation in the shape of the solid takes place, and about that we had studied the various properties. Now, in this topic, there is a little bit variation, and the variation is in the sense that when that force is being applied by the liquid, or that force is applied on the liquid, then what are the properties of the liquid we are going to observe, or what are the properties of liquid which are related to the mechanical part, or force is applied, or mechanics, due to the mechanics or force applied, what are the properties of the liquid going to be varied? That thing we will study under this chapter, that is mechanical properties of fluids. So, first of all, we have to understand what is the meaning of fluids, what are called fluids. Fluids are what? Fluids are nothing, fluids are that which can flow. Fluids can be defined as the materials which can flow. And what materials, what things do you have the knowledge that can flow? So the things which can flow, water, or you can say that liquid or air. So liquid and air both collectively called as fluids. As you know that the fluids, under the action of the force, under the action of force, fluids can flow. Means, to make the motion of the fluid, as you had observed that how water can flow, there is a pressure difference. If there is no pressure difference, the water cannot flow. Or air flows, wind flow due to the pressure difference. Pressure difference is created and wind starts flowing from higher pressure to lower pressure. So the pressure density is necessary for the flow of fluid. Means force is applied, and if force is there, the fluid can flow. So we had written, under the action of force, fluids can flow. Now, you have to know that in fluid mechanics, this part is called as, because mechanics is applied with fluids, so this is also called as fluid mechanics. And as we are discussing about fluid mechanics, so mechanics has two parts. You know that mechanics has two parts, that is statics and dynamics. Similarly, the fluid mechanics has two parts, fluid statics, or you can say that hydrostatics. What is the meaning of fluid statics or hydrostatics? Fluid statics or hydrostatics means to say that when we study about the fluid at rest, study about the fluid at rest, Fluid at rest to means to say that there is no motion or the fluid is in equilibrium. When we are talking about the fluid at rest, we consider that the fluid is in equilibrium, means net forces acting on the fluid is equal to zero. And second is fluid dynamics or hydrodynamics. Hydrodynamics. In fluid dynamics or hydrodynamics, we will study about the fluid which is in motion. Study about fluid in, we will study about fluid in motion, means river is flowing, water in the river is flowing, from air is flowing, or wind, that is called wind, water is coming down from higher mountain, that is a spring you call. So these things are the examples of fluid dynamics or motion of fluid. Motion of fluid, and the motion of fluid takes place when there is the external force or the force is applied on the fluid. So now we will start our discussion. We will start our discussion with the topic, that is fluid statics or hydrostatics. Fluid statics or hydrostatics. And later on, the in later section we will discuss about the fluid dynamics or hydrodynamics. So first of all, concentrate over fluid statics or hydrostatics. Fluid statics or hydrostatics. Fluid statics or hydrostatics. For studying hydrostatics, what we have to study? We have to study about the fluid at rest. And as in the case of fluid at rest, we will study the net change in momentum, the normal change in momentum due to the molecules of the liquid which are in their random motion due to their thermal velocity. Suppose I am taking a container, look at the container, okay, and in this container there is a liquid, okay. Now due to the thermal, this is kept at 25 degrees Celsius, that is room temperature. That is 25 degrees Celsius. Now there are various molecules of the liquid. And these molecules of the liquid interact with each other. As these molecules of the liquid interact with each other, they are interacting with each other, then they must apply the force on the surface of the liquid. And whatever the force they are applying, that force results in the change in momentum. Change in momentum for a unit interval of time. So the change in momentum for a unit interval of time, that is called as thrust exerted by the liquid molecules. So we will discuss about the thrust. And what is thrust? Thrust is the normal change in momentum of the liquid molecules due to their intermolecular interaction, intermolecular in a unit interval of time, unit and do you know what is the change of momentum per unit time? Change of momentum per unit time, that is the normal force. So thrust is nothing, thrust is the normal force, normal force acting on the layers of liquid, layers of liquid. So thrust can be defined as, thrust can be defined as the normal force which is acting on the layers of the liquid. Okay, so this is about the thrust. Now we will discuss about the equilibrium of liquid, equilibrium of liquid placed in the container. Yes students, now you know about the liquid. When liquid has a key property or fluids have a key property, all the fluids have a key property that they can change their shape with the applied force, without offering a little resistance. It means to say that, what does it mean? It means to say that suppose you had placed water in the balloon, and after that when a small force is being applied on the balloon, when a very small force is applied on the balloon, the balloon will change its shape and offers a very little resistance to the applied force, or it can resist very little for the applied force, whatever the force you had applied, because the resistance is very low. So it can easily change, or a liquid can easily change its shape by the application of the force. So in hydrostatics we will study about the force which can change the shape. Due to this fact only the liquids can occupy the shape of the container, whatever the container you had placed, which type of container you had placed the liquid can occupy the shape of the container. Because if this property is not in the solids, then the shape of the liquid is not going to be changed, and it cannot change their shape according to the container. So if the liquids have large resistance value, then whatever the force applied by the surface of the container, they restricts the force which is applied by the surface of the container, and due to that they cannot change their shape according to the shape of the container. So they have, liquids have or fluids have very little resistance. Suppose for example I am taking from a real life that there is a two type of person, a rigid person. The rigid person is like that, he says whatever you are saying, there is no effect of that thoughts on that person, and he is the very much rigid. And a flexible person is that who can accommodate himself in any type of environment, because he is flexible and he can modulate himself according to the situation. So liquids are just similar like that, they can resist very little of what the force being applied and take the shape of the body or shape of the container in which it is kept. So this is about the hydrodynamics. Now we are going to discuss about the liquid in equilibrium, liquid in equilibrium condition. Dear students, here in this case I will prove that when the force is applied on any liquid particle which is kept in the container is normal to the surface of the liquid or normal to, or tangential to the surface of the liquid and normal to the surface of the container. Normal to the surface of the container and tangential to the surface of the liquid, then that force is equal to zero. That force is can be considered as zero and the body is in rest. Means if normal force is acting on the surface of the container by the liquid, if normal force is acting on the surface of the container by the liquid, then the force is supposed to be equal to zero, and under the action of that force the liquid will be in equilibrium. So look at the condition here. Suppose I am taking a liquid, okay, and this is the surface of the liquid and this is the surface of the container. This is the surface of the liquid and this is the surface of the container. Suppose there is point P here, there is point P here, and we had supposed that a force F is acting at an angle theta, a force F is acting at an angle theta with the surface of the liquid, with the surface of the liquid, then this force has two components, F cos theta and another component is F sine theta, F cos theta and F sine theta. Now look at here, the component of force which is along the surface of the container, component of force along F cos theta and F cos theta is equal to zero. F cos theta and this is equal to zero. And if F cos theta is equal to 0, then F is not equal to 0, F cannot be equal to 0. F cannot be equal to 0, and if F cannot be equal to 0 means cos theta is equal to 0, cos theta is equal to 0, and when the cos theta is equal to 0, cos theta is equal to cos pi by 2, and here theta is equal to pi by 2. Means if this angle is theta and if this angle theta is perpendicular to the surface of the container, means if force is perpendicular to the surface of container, if the force is perpendicular to the surface of the container, then liquid is said to be in equilibrium. Yes, students. So we can say that if the liquid is in equilibrium, if the liquid converse of this thing, if the liquid is in equilibrium, if the liquid is in equilibrium, then net force is always perpendicular to the surface. Net force, whatever the net force acting on the liquid, is always perpendicular to the surface. Means if F is perpendicular to the surface of the liquid, perpendicular to the surface of the liquid, then liquid is said to be equilibrium, or if the liquid is in equilibrium, then net force always perpendicular to the surface of the liquid. And here F cos theta is equal to 0. We had considered F cos theta is equal to 0, means if there are two, if we had considered a force is applying and a force F is acting on the liquid at an angle theta, now we had resolved into its two components, that is tangential component and perpendicular component. And since the liquid is at rest, so tangential force is 0. Since the liquid is at rest, so tangential force F tangential is equal to 0. And what is the force on the, because if F tangential is not equal to 0, then liquid will flow in this direction. So we have to consider F tangential is equal to 0, and since F tangential is equal to 0, means F cos theta is equal to 0, and of F cos theta, and from here we had calculated theta is equal to pi by 2, means whatever the forces which are acting on the body, this perpendicular force is equal to 0. So whatever the forces acting on the body is only in the downward direction, that is F sin theta, this direction the forces will act, only this direction of forces normal to the surface. This is the surface of the liquid, there is a surface of the liquid, and the force acting only in this direction, because this direction of forces is equal to 0. And if the forces are acting in this direction, then they have the tendency to move the liquid or make the liquid to flow. Okay, so the liquid is not flowing. So the whatever in equilibrium condition, whatever the forces acting on the body, they are always in the perpendicular direction to the surface of the liquid. Okay, students. So this is the condition for the liquid in equilibrium. I think that you had understood it. Now we will discuss about the next topic, that is pressure. What is pressure?